awesome day. So today I just did a day of eating, a typical day of what I eat every day, kind of stuff, you know, more or less. I start every day off by having a cup of bulletproof coffee, and then I have something with it. It's either cereal or some kind of egg or something with it, and then into lunch and eating at work. So of course you can't film at work, so but you'll see what I made to bring to work with me. And then of course dinner tonight. I mean, I didn't show you my eating, but if you want to see me eating, let me know down in the comments below, and next time I'll just film while I'm eating. I just showed you what I was eating. And then I'm going to go through the macros at the end of the day, and we'll show you what that looks like, all right? So, hope you enjoyed it. Hope you like it. Subscribe. Hit that little bell icon over here. I'd really appreciate it. Thumbs up. Thumbs up is the algorithm that tells YouTube that you like it, and that it will start suggesting it to more people. So, I'd really appreciate the thumbs up. So, all right. Have a great day, and hope you enjoy my day of eating.
Well, good morning. I thought I'd do a day of eating. I'm just waking up. It's about 5:30 in the morning, so it's really early. So I just thought I'd kind of quickly go through it. I could show you Amy eating, but I'll show you what I eat, and then we'll go through the macros at the end of the day. Hopefully I'll wake up here, and we're doing this too as well. So I'm going to start off by every morning, give me the coffee pot warming up. I have a bulletproof coffee. I did a video on that earlier. I'll put the link to that down below if you're interested. So let's go make my coffee real quick. Put in a little sweetener, in some of this collagen peptide. I do use collagen every day. This is the creamer I put in my coffee. Love getting up early in the morning and starting the day. I'm sure the video quality will be less than normal. Far from being awake. So I put a little bit of MTC oil in there, about a teaspoon of MTC oil in there. A little bit of ghee in there. garlic butter, all it is. It cleared out all the milk solids and stuff. It doesn't have to be refrigerated, which is nice. It actually is great to cook with because it has a much higher boiling point than the butter. So it actually is easier to cook with. And then this coconut oil. I'm just about the end of it. This is a great way to start getting your fats in every day too, so. I took my little frother thing in. It really stirs up the coffee good. Alright. So step one is done, that's coffee. I try to keep my breakfast as simple and easy because I get up early. It's everybody else is still sleeping. I do some meal prepping. This is actually the bacon, egg, and cheese muffins that I make. So all I do is I take a couple of these because it's really easy to do and just throw them in the microwave. Let me get a tissue. And then, you can go to the store and you can pay $2 for a package, or you can make one of these things for $1, give that. More like 50 cents. So really that's it. The coffee comes out to be like one net carb. The muffin tins are like one net carb for two of them. So it's a pretty easy breakfast, pretty low carb breakfast. Kind of get my way started. I'm going to pause it here. I'm going to eat my breakfast and then I'll come back and I'll show you what I'm going to make for lunch. All right. All right, it's time to make my lunch. So, I make lunches really easy. This is just an ice pack I put in my cooler for lunch. I don't like to eat a lot of complicated stuff. And at work right now, it's kind of crazy because we don't have our cafeterias aren't open with all that's going on in the world. I'm hoping that they'll open up soon. So all I think I'm going to do is, my wife actually made me some tuna. This is a tuna thing that she makes. It's tuna and a hard-boiled egg and mayonnaise. So she mixes it together. I'm actually going to take, you see these egg life. So the egg whites are zero carbs, zero fiber, 5 protein. So all it is basically is just egg white wrap. So I'm going to open these up and I'm going to pop a couple of these out. Show you the snack I'm gonna bring. Cut this open. Get a bag too. Yeah, this is just something quick and easy. Sit down and relax a little bit. So they're just egg whites.
So I take two of them. And I just make a wrap with the tuna mix. Again, tuna is zero carbs as well. These are zero carbs. So again, it's a nice, quick, easy lunch. I will not. Sometimes I'll bring put cheese on them, sometimes I won't. Today I'm not going to. And everything every day is different. Sometimes I make a salad. I actually got this really cool little lunch bag that like yesterday I brought chicken with me for lunch. And the new lunch bag has a little heating element in it. So you can throw it in there about an hour before you eat, you plug it in, and plug it under my desk. And then when I eat, it's hot. I don't have to worry about going heating up food anywhere else or around anybody else. So it's really, really good. So that's all there really is here. And then let me show, let's go grab a couple things I'm going to have with it. Going in our messy pantry. I'm actually going to grab one of these Quest chips things. And I think I'm going to take one of these high-key snacks with me. So those are going to be the snacks to go in with my lunch. Again, I won't eat all the high-keys. There's two servings in this thing, so I'll probably eat it a little bit today and a little bit tomorrow. Carbs on the other ones, four carbs on these. This has one carb per serving. So that's pretty much my lunch. That's all there is to it. Pretty easy. Like I said, I'm not making anything complicated. I like easy. I like quick. I like fast. So that's it for my lunch. We'll talk to you. I may try to eat lunch. Let me get down to the camera. I may try to eat lunch outside so that I can just kind of show you what it looks like as I put it out there. Again, that tuna spread will last me 2 days. I'll eat a little bit today and then maybe again in a day or two. I'll eat another sandwich. But it's a little bit about meal prepping so that you can just do it quick and easy. That's the best thing that I can tell you. Saturdays and Sundays, we do a lot of extra stuff. I know I made that, like I said, later today you'll probably see a video out. I should say, you'll see a video out of the cheeseburger, the bacon cheddar cheeseburger casserole. And we divided it into a bunch of different meals. So we have that. We grilled a bunch of chicken. So we had that. That's what I had for dinner last night. So more to come. Talk to you in a little bit. Hi everybody, it's dinner time now. So you saw a little bit this morning what I had for breakfast. You saw what I packed for lunch and I ate at lunch. It was good. Again, I ate two of those wraps with that tuna. It was really good. I didn't eat the Quest chips that I brought with me this morning, so I have those for a later time. I'll probably eat those sometime during the week. My wife and I had talked about maybe getting cheeseburgers from one of our local, we have a really good cheeseburger place. We get it without the buns. And I actually made some chaffle hamburger buns. We have them in the refrigerator. We'll probably have those when we have those. And then I'll bring the chips with us to replace the French fries. But I wanted to show you, this is my dinner. So this is what I'm having. I'm gonna have some chicken. We did some meal prepping on Sunday. We did some meal prepping on Sunday and we barbecued a bunch of chicken. So I got a couple of thighs and a couple of little legs here that we're gonna have. Then I got about a half a cup of broccoli that I'm gonna have with it. so I'm gonna put that in the microwave. I'm gonna heat it up and I'm gonna have that.
I will tell you that the chicken is zero carbs, and I think the broccoli is like three carbs or something like that. Again, you know, pretty healthy, staying under my carbs for today. Not so sure about the protein because of the chicken and the tuna and stuff. So we'll have to see how that goes and see how that goes. So at the end here, after I'm done eating, we'll get together again. We'll go through what the macros breakdown were and talk about how the day went and, you know, how all the food came out. Again, pretty good. It's hard to say that it's a, you know, watching my weight. So, but it's been really, really good. So over 3 years now. So, hey, if you like this kind of stuff, make sure you're subscribing, hitting the bell icon. Tell me what you like. You like to see more of the day of eating. So you want to see what I'm eating during the day. You want to see, you know, product reviews. Talked about doing maybe some protein bars and seeing what the different protein bars are out there and which ones taste good. So talked about doing that. Other product reviews, you let me know. If there's other things you want to see, other things you want to see cooked. Talked about probably making some chocolate chip muffins coming up and some other things. Whatever you'd like to see, let me know. I have an Oreo recipe for chaffle Oreos. I think I'm going to try that sometime in the next couple of days as well. It sounds interesting, a little different. So if you're thinking stuff in here that you'd like to see, please subscribe. I really appreciate it, right? So I'm going to end this and I'm going to eat my dinner and then we'll come back after I'm done and we'll kind of go through our macros for the day. Who knows? Maybe I have enough room to have a nice, delicious peanut butter fat bomb. So it's in the evening, just relaxing. I'm gonna watch probably a TV show or two and get ready for bed here. Ready for work tomorrow. I'm gonna do it all over again, right? But I thought I'd just kind of review what I ate today, some of the macros, what we did and how my day went. And kind of, it's a pretty typical day. I'm not gonna say there's anything unique about today. I didn't go out of my way for anything. We do some meal prepping and stuff, so it makes it a lot easier. We do that on Saturdays and Sundays. Some of the cooking videos, you'll see some of the things I eat, throughout the week as well. So it actually kind of works out nicely, cook on the weekends and then eat all week long. So here's what I go through. So I had for breakfast, I had the Bulletproof coffee. And again, if you're interested in seeing how I make that, I'll put the link down below. And then I had the egg cup. The bacon, egg, and cheese muffins, or cups, muffins, whatever you want to call it. I'll put the link for that down below. I make those pretty regularly. They're easy to make. You whip them up, throw them in the oven for a little bit, and come out. And then I have enough for 2 weeks for breakfasts. So they're really, really easy to make. And then for lunch, I took one of those egg life wraps. It's one of those white egg wraps, and I used that. Let me go back there. So breakfast, between the Bulletproof coffee and the muffins, it was four carbs for breakfast. Lunch was the Egg Life wraps. I had two of them. I used the tuna, the mayonnaise, the Primal Kitchen mayonnaise, which is the olive avocado oil mayonnaise. And then hard-boiled egg mixed in with it. So that gave me one carb for lunch. So one carb for all of lunch. Now I did bring Quest with chips with me, but I didn't eat them because I was full and I didn't feel I needed to. I'll save them for a later date and eat them with something else. I did have a snack. I brought some High Key cookies with me, and I had one serving of the High Key cookies, which is if you haven't had them, they're really pretty good. They're not the cheapest in the world either, but they're only one carb per serving, so I had one serving, so that was one carb for the snack. And then for dinner, I ate the chicken, and there were thighs and small legs. And then I had about a half a cup of broccoli. So that was a total of three carbs for dinner. And then I did, after dinner, I waited a little while. So it's been a couple hours since I ate. So we did wait a little while. I did have, right after dinner, like I said before, I tried to eat some kind of berry or something afterwards. So I ate about a third of a cup of the blackberries.
which is about 2 carbs for the third of a cup. And then I ate later in the evening, I ate a half a serving of the Lily's dark chocolate one. So that was 2 carbs as well. So it's just one of those sections across. The Lily's is a pretty big bar. So I just wanted a little taste of something. So I'm a snacker. So I got to eat something that snacks on. So that's good. I could just eat that little piece and I'm done. I'm done for the night. I'm full. I'm satisfied. I don't need to eat anything else. So here's the breakdown. So for the day, I had a total of 7 net carbs, which is really, really low for me. Usually I don't have it that low. And mainly it's because of the chicken I ate and the wraps that I ate. Usually I'll eat more than that. And usually a lot of times 1 or 2 of these meals would be a lot more than that. But because of the lunch was really low and then the dinner was really low, right? So that's why it was so low. So 7 carbs for the day, net carbs, I should say, for the day. Protein was at 140. So that meant I went way over on my protein. I should have been at 102 grams. So I went over on my protein because of the tuna and the chicken and the eggs. So my protein was high today. Normally I try to keep it pretty close to where I should be. And generally I do hit that or come close to it. You're not going to hit it every day. You're not going to hit it all the time. You just, you know, you got to kind of try to come in the ballpark. My fat was 107 out of 127. So I was a little bit low on my fat. And generally that's the one, out of the two, I try to come closer to my fat generally than I do my protein. So, because the fat is what you're going to use for energy and that's what you kind of need to keep going. So to me, the fat content is more important than the protein. But, you know, with the collagen that I take in the morning with the Bulletproof coffee, and plus, like I said, with the chicken and the tuna and the eggs and all that stuff, it was high today, which is okay. No big deal, you know. And then calories, I did 1,628 calories today out of a goal of 1,639 calories. So pretty close, only 10 calories short. I did think about eating a peanut butter fat bomb tonight to increase my fat a little bit, but I'm not going to. I'm done for the day. So those are my macros for the day. I do track every day. I use that carb manager. It's not always accurate, so you got to make sure you're checking it, because some other people put data into the system, so it's only as good as you put it in. So you might have to go in and make some adjustments if you use it. But I do use it. It's a good tool. It's a good idea. You can use it in a grocery store as a scanning feature and scan the groceries and see whether it's good or bad or indifferent, and see what Carb Manager has to say about it. Again, you know, it's only as good as the data that puts in. So if somebody puts garbage into it, you're going to get garbage out of it. So you have to be careful, you know, check the label or check the recipe and see what it says versus what the tracker says. But it's a good way of knowing how you're doing it. So that was how my day went. Again, you know, try to make sure you're hitting those macros. I don't really count calories. I don't worry about my calories. I'm just worried about staying under my carbs and hitting my fat. Most important to me, most important, I guess, is staying under my carbs and then hitting my fat and then the protein. And I don't even worry about carbs. I've been doing this for 3+ years. It's been working for me. I don't have to count anything. It's you know, counting calories is that other plan. You know, it's not this plan. I've never counted them and worked great. So I would suggest you do the same thing. All right. So hopefully you enjoyed it. If you have any questions, you know, comment down below what you have for questions. Again, please subscribe, thumbs up. That's how YouTube knows whether you like it or not like it. All right. And then I will see you on the next video. And have an awesome evening.